Hey, people, what is up?
Dexter, say what's up to everybody.
He's in there making a lot of racket. Be quiet, I'm trying to do something. Anyway, so what is up, people? I just got back in the house. I went outside to take out my trash bag, put it in the garbage can, check my mail. This and that and the other. And as I was walking out the front door, down the steps, down the sidewalk, and around the bush, I stopped dead in my tracks and dropped the trash bag and damn near pissed myself. Why, you ask? Well, I'm glad you asked. Because I damn near stepped on a gigantic fucking snake. You know that old expression, if it would have been a snake, it would have bit you? Yeah, something like that. I got footage of it, too. I ran back in the house and, you know, ran back outside with my camera and tried to get some footage of this big-ass snake going in my damn bushes. But I damn near stepped on him. I came real close, and I didn't really see what kind it was, you know. I'm not the most well-versed in snake species, you know, like, which ones are which, but I mean, I know the main ones, you know, I know which ones not to fuck with. The ones that go with their tail and they got diamonds on the back of them and, you know, diamond shaped heads and shit like that. And, you know, the real bright green ones and the ones with red and black and yellow. And I know not to fuck with those, but, you know, the other ones, they kind of just all mixed together to me. It was big though. I got footage. I'm gonna probably roll that in on the end of this video. And I got my trash taken out, but not before I dropped the damn thing and jumped back like a motherfucker. My wife would have laughed her ass off, cause I'm always like, you know, snakes don't bother me that much. You know, spiders I don't like. Them motherfuckers can be anywhere. You know, they can just come down on top of you from a web. You know, silent little fuckers. Snakes I can usually spot, you know. So I'm always telling my wife, you know, and I don't worry about the snakes, man. The spiders is what I don't like. Well, she would have laughed her ass off because I jumped about 10 feet back when I saw that snake at my feet. Man, I swear. I mean, I'm not scared of them, or I wouldn't have even ran out there and got the camera and got as close as I did to it. But I still don't fuck with them. I'm not stupid. Maybe a little crazy, but I ain't stupid. And I'm not fucking with snakes, especially when I can't identify if they can bite me and send me to the ER or not. Dexter, what do you want, buddy? Are you just waiting? You waiting on something? Look how big he got, y'all. Now keep in mind, I don't have a little hand. Choo-choo. You ready to do this? You listening to me ramble? There's Sammy. What are you doing? Where you been? Y'all don't see him much. He don't do much around here. Hides under the bed pretty much. And there's Biscuits. Kelly Biscuits. Come here. What you doing, girlfriend? Hey. Come here. They're all in here. Y'all just listening to me ramble or what? Okay, let me get on with what I'm supposed to be getting on with. After I did all that little, you know, this, that, and the other with the snake, I ran to the mailbox. Well, I didn't run to the mailbox. I went to the mailbox. Very carefully looking down at the ground, I'm at Ed. You know, because I got a little rattled by that. I ain't gonna lie, you know. I mean, you know, that fucker was big. He was long as shit, too. I mean, at least a good 5 foot long. But I went to the mailbox, opened the mailbox, and I found something in the mailbox. And we are gonna open that. That's right, y'all. This right here is a little package right here from my boy Bonham. 771, y'all. I'll put a link down there in the description box. Go check out his channel, y'all. He's into the blades, and you know, he got some cool stuff going on his channel. So go over there and show the boy some love. I think he's a good dude. Been supporting me for a while, so, you know. And he sent me something, so we're going to see what it is. I always like to see what kind of surprises people give me. I'm very, very grateful for this kind of stuff, y'all. There's the Ambitious. I think that's the Ambitious. I don't know. This, I call them all the tenacious. You know, you got the big tenacious, you got the regular medium tenacious, then you got the little tenacious. Then you got the kind of large, medium tenacious. So, they're all the tenacious. All right, what we got here? We got a note. Hi. Well, hey to you too, Bonham. Let's see what's in there. I guess maybe I should read the note first. I don't know. I know what it is, though. I just dumped it out on the desk. Let me read the note. Hold on. Dexter, would you quit licking the note? Dexter's always very... Come here. What are you doing? He's always very interested in... look. You want to read it? Huh? He always wants to know what I'm getting in the mail. Every time I open something up in a package, he always has to come over here and look. What do you want? Want to smell it? What is it? You smell Bonham? Hmm? Yep. That's who that came from, so that's who you're smelling, buddy. Hey, Exacto. I hope you enjoy this stuff as much as I enjoy your vids. Well, where'd it go? Say hi to Shy Guy. Yeah. You get a Shy Guy one day too, brother. That's awesome, man. I really do appreciate it. If I can find some more of these Shy Guys, I can't find them everywhere. I send them all, you know, to my people, to my friends out there that want a Shy Guy. But I can't seem to find them at the store. I found a few, but... Man, these things are getting hard to find. Whenever I wasn't looking for them, I seen them all over the place. So, either way, let's see what he gave me. Look at this, y'all. A black and white lanyard. That's cool as hell. I love the black and white. I got a similar one from my boy Blade Spec. And this one right here is a little bit longer. And I really like that color scheme. Check that out. Black and white. Awesome. Look good on my white Endura. And here's some fat ones right here. Check these out. These are cool. See that? These are good to hold on to. If you got something that you really need to, you know, use the lanyard to get a grip on, these are flat and fat. So you get a real good, you know, grip on them if you need... Like, say you got to withdraw something from your pocket, you got in a tight pocket or something. These just, they lay flat against the pocket, and they give you a good grip. So I do like these kind a lot. These are like, I believe these are like a double Cobra, something like that, they call them. I'm not real sure about, you know, paracord making or paracord craft is not my specialty. I don't know a lot about it, but I do know when they're made good. And these are made good right here. They're real tight. Bonham, you did a good job, bro. Good tight quality on that. So, those are awesome. There's a green one. Uh-oh. And, here's another one. This is a little box knot with a little wooden bead on it. I love the box knots. The box knots are what I use the most. I know how to make those. Maybe that's why I use them, because I actually know how to make them, but that's cool. I always like the box knots, especially on some of my flashlights. If I use a lanyard, I use a box knot. They're my favorites. So there's those. Thank you so much, my friend. Thank you. That stuff, I really appreciate stuff like that, and I won't forget it. So, I'm going to go ahead. It's 8 minutes already. Damn. 9 minutes. I'm going to go ahead and cut this off. I'll probably clip in the snake footage, at least some of it of me rambling about the snake and showing the snake and poking at the snake and, you know, all this shit. So, yeah. Y'all, thank you so much for watching. And Bonham771, go check out his channel, y'all. Good guy. Thank you, brother, for the paracord. Definitely love that. Check this shit out, y'all. See that? Going up in my motherfucking house. I don't know what the fuck that is. But he's a big motherfucking snake. See right there, y'all? Right there. See? There he goes. God damn. That's a motherfucking monster. I don't know where the hell he's going. He's in them damn bushes somewhere, though. I don't know where. Hope that motherfucker don't go in the house, man. I mean, I like snakes and shit. They're cool to look at, but god damn, he was long. Didn't look poisonous. I couldn't really see the head too much. I mean, the coloration can be a little misleading, I guess, but I'm guessing. I walked out here and I was gonna take my trash right there. Woo! I'm guessing he came from right there, y'all. See that hole? Anyway, I walked out here and I was gonna take my trash, you know? I'm walking around here. And I get here, I wasn't looking down at the ground, and I stepped down and I saw this motherfucker. I about jumped 10 feet back. God. But I jumped straight back. I didn't see that motherfucker going across my path there, y'all. I'm glad I keep aware of my surroundings good enough not to have stepped on him, just in case. But, that scared the shit out of me, y'all. Snakes don't usually scare me. I mean, I've picked them up and shit before, you know, big ones, and they don't usually scare me, but when they do that, whenever I don't see them, he's in there somewhere. He's camouflaging himself inside there. I ain't about to step inside that shit. I'm not that good of a snake handler to step in there and see what's going on, so. But I really don't want him going in the house. I don't know if y'all can see it, but that, I'm telling you right now, that was a healthy snake compared to what we usually see around here. And I've seen a couple of rattlers and several copperheads around here. But he was just walking across right there, or walking, crawling, whatever, you slithering across. And I stepped like right there, y'all. He was going right there. I was like that close. I'm glad his head wasn't there. I'm glad he wasn't temperamental. Usually the snakes we have around here are not too temperamental. Except for that rattler. That rattler I saw that one time, man, I don't think I would have really wanted to touch him. I guess, my guess is he was coming from over there and he's going in there and he's gonna try to get back to this hole. So he'll probably be coming out over here in a little bit, as long as I ain't here. I'm pretty sure he knows where I'm at right now, but I don't know where he is. I'm gonna have to keep the camera keep it ready just in case I come out here and see him again. Ah, man, I'm going back in the house. How is that for an early morning piss in your pants? I mean, you know, I damn near kicked the fucker. Not really used to that kind of thing. I mean, we get a little bit, but we don't really get a whole lot of snakes out in the front yard in the morning, you know. Usually they'll come out at night, but whatever. All right, y'all, I'm gonna go ahead and cut this off. So if I see him again, I'll edit some video in. If not, life's short, y'all. Stay sharp.